After all those years in the underground, the air of the surface seemed incredibly fresh, intoxicating. But that was not what had caused the crew's euphoria. Our journey finally got a definite purpose provided by the transmission from the government bunker in the Urals. For 20 years, we thought that neither the government nor military high command had survived. Turns out they're still around. Where were they while we were eating each other alive in the metro? We'll have a lot of questions for them once we reach Yamantau, if we reach it. The ruins of our country are under enemy control, according to Miller, and we'll have to fight through to our goal. A small team against the occupation armies? What are the chances that we'll succeed? That we'll get some answers?
Froze anything off yet, darling?
Here, let's warm you up a little bit.
So, what do you think our chances of getting to Yamantau alive are? It's the only thing on my father's mind. How to earn his forgiveness, get back to Metro and his old life, the life you had always been running from. And to think, I never believed you. And now I'm looking at this fog, thinking it could actually be hiding our new life from us. By the way, we should be approaching the bridge soon. Damn it! A campfire! People! There are people there! Hit the brakes!
Shots fired! Four bogeys on a trolley!
Are you all right, Artyom?
It's the Zelda!
How bad is it? Can we move?
No, we're stuck!
Oh, shit!
Damn fog. Seems we ran through someone's roadblock.
Who was it? Any uniforms?
None. They were wearing rags.
Just some old farts.
Old farts, huh? That's just the perimeter guard. They could put anyone there, even women and children.
Do you really think we found them, Colonel?
Well, we can't be sure. I was expecting to run into them much earlier. The trolley is headed towards the bridge. Some fortifications there. This looks peaceful. A village and a church on the water. We need intel. Here, Artyom, I put a mark on your map. Get there and find out what you can about that bridge. Taking a prisoner would be ideal. Anna, you cover him.
Yes, sir.
May I go with Artyom too? As backup?
No. Until we figure out our situation, you are not to take a step away from the
Let's
Aurora.
Let's go, Artyom!
These two can handle themselves just fine. Yermak, when can you get the Aurora running again?
I don't know yet!
Artyom, don't forget your backpack. It's a new module. A portable workshop, so to speak. The manual is inside. It doesn't come with crafting materials, though, so keep an eye out for those.
Yes, sir.
Let's move out, Artyom.
Just be careful out there.
Sure thing.
I gotta say, that was one flimsy roadblock. And those guys, well, they didn't look like army men at all. Just old men.
Be careful out there. Most of the country has been destroyed or occupied.
What was that? Could you check it out?
That electric tower there looks like a perfect sniping position. Let's go. Look, a rabbit! Okay, Artyom, I'll climb up there while you take the boat to the church. I'll call you when I'm settled. Break a leg.
Our father, Silanthius, has already started his sermon. Just enter the temple and see the light of truth. We are a peaceful lot, so...
here either. Silanthius locked us up here a year ago. Yes, the bridge dwellers won't even talk to heretics. But I'll tell you everything I've seen in this place all that year. Oh, it's the bridge guard. Silanthius fooled them just like the locals. But unlike them, the bridge guard have guns. Run! There's a way out down here and there's a boat at the dock.
We also have one, but it's too small for all of us.
What the fuck was that? A whale? It's fucking huge!
The old man sent me out as a forward sentry. Told me that I was to this side and under no circumstances look for any. I had a blunt-roll keep working with it.
Thank you.
should have landed on that field. We were still flying, and it looked like we could have gone on for some time. And then I can't power for that. So what difference does that make anyway? We're not going to Moscow from here, that's for sure.
Here's Artyom, back from the abyss of NATO occupation.
You're alive! Impressive, after the horrors Duke told us about. Let's go. Dad's talking to Katya right now. They are so nice, both Katya and her daughter. And Katya's medical training will come in handy.
Thank you for the information, Katya. But there is one more question I need to ask.
But of course.
What do you know of the occupation forces?
Huh? I'm sorry, I don't quite get what you...
So, you've never seen any foreign army in this area?
No, I haven't seen any army. But we haven't really been to any important places.
I see. Artyom, a moment.
Thank you, Artyom. If not for you, we'd never have
escaped
that place.
Stop by my desk once you're done talking to the old man. I've got something for you.
Great job saving them, Artyom. Katya here has provided us with vital information. A mechanic called Crest is hiding in the port. His help is required if we're to fix the Aurora in the foreseeable future. Yermak can't handle the repairs alone. So, once you're ready, go to the port and invite Crest to join us. And then get back ASAP. We'll have to decide what to do about the fanatics on that bridge. Now we know for sure that the bridge is in working order. They crossed it last year when they got here. There might not even be any enemy forces around here at all. They probably...
Yes, Uncle Tom. Thank you. And your wife is great. She's kind, really strong. Thank you, Uncle.
You're pretty amazing, bratuha. That was crazy. Blin, those mutants are pretty hardcore. The villagers I never have a chance against them. You just cut through them, blin. Well, it's pleasure to meet you. Name's Krist, by the way. Are you from the train? Bet the locals wouldn't even talk to you guys. Opened fire right away, didn't they? Of course, those dumb bastards. I've been here long enough to know the drill. They have a cult over there. The dumbasses are hung up on technology having destroyed the old world. So they don't exactly take kindly to smart guys here. And me? Well, they were just gonna lock me up until I agreed to go fight those electrical demons of theirs to absolve my sins. Because I was in cahoots with Satan, apparently, блядь. Some Satanist I am. I've been fixing engines and trading all my life. Now I'm moving to the east. Blin, I'm sick of this part of country. There's just nothing to do here anymore. The cities are gone. Bandits, beasts all around. Lots of space across the Volga, though. Plenty of opportunity. So I came here with my rail car full of trading goods, hoping to make a few sales on the way east. What a fool I was. I was lucky to get out alive. Anyway, since you've arrived, I've been thinking of this little plan I had, never had a chance to pull off alone, but since you guys are also going east... Now, judging by what I could see with my binoculars, it's a miracle your engine is still running. Oh, by the way, take the binoculars. I'll show you where everything is. Look at the bridge first. See that section on top? It should lower if the emergency mechanism still works. Katya from the church should know better. I've never been to the bridge myself. There to the right, that huge hangar. That's a terminal, blin. The cult is considered a holy place, covered at all in graffiti, schmaffiti. Their tsarfish lived there, you know. Stupid bastards. Even further right, see the building near all those carriages? Used to be a train depot. There are some bandits there now, but the place itself ain't bad. Oh, the area nearby isn't too bad either. There's a good hunting and stuff. I set up several safe camps around there. If you find them, you could rest, fix your equipment, unless you prefer spending nights at an open campfire. Now, come on, let me show you my home now. Here is my cave. And this is where I live. Not a palace. One. Oh, here's a bed. So if you're tired, my home is your home. I made a workbench to tinker on. If you need ammo or grenades, there's some raw materials here. So help yourself. You can have anything you like here. Can't carry all the shit anyway. Come on, don't be shy. Anyhow, gotta tell you, this isn't just a pretty face. I've got a whole lot of knowledge stored up in here. And look at these hands. They know how to fix stuff. You'll never have second thoughts about picking me up. Some smokes from the villagers before the assholes chase me away. Now, you could take the zipline down, just hook up and away you go. Dumb cretins didn't like my light. I've been banned from the village and the bridge ever since.
Stuck here for good.
Artyom, I heard you call me. It was so great there. But I heard you and couldn't leave you.
Thank you. on, we're coming for you!
Anna! What's wrong? Anna!
God damn it.
We have to tell the others that we found her, Sam.
Guys!
It's good Artyom found me.
Oh, what is this place?
See the barrels? They're chemicals of some kind. This place is either for storage or it's a dump. That shore could have been put there by the locals to mark the spot.
Thank you, my love.
Oh, okay, all right. So, Artyom, let's pick her up now?
No way in hell. I can walk just fine. I'll just rest a bit and get going.
The old man's probably going seven sorts of crazy now, thinking his precious daughter got hurt or something.
Dad, it's me. My radio battery died. I got it wet. Other than that, I'm fine. Artyom and the guys are here.
Anna, one day I will have a heart attack because of you. You are getting attention once you are back, young lady. Sam, is that you? Thanks for helping fight Anna. Now I want you to drag her butt here with extreme prejudice. Time to talk some sense into this fight. Stepan's asking for some too. Trying to get civilians on board. Everyone's gone nuts here.
Head back. Help Stepan persuade my father about letting Katya and Nastya travel with us. Artyom, I am feeling better now. Really, I am.
So, Sam, tell me what the real enemy bases look like so that we know when we see it.
Well, first of all, there are these huge humanoid robots, all plastered with stars and stripes, with nuclear reactors up their asses.
Artyom, help us here. The old man won't let Katya and Nastya come with us. Even though Katya told us where to find them.
We have to go back now, I guess.
Hi, Artyom.
All right, welcome to the crew.
Well, thank you. What let you down?
I don't know.
Hey, Artyom, see how it all worked out?
Come here, Artyom. Have a seat. Look, we have an opportunity to cross the bridge without an assault. There are trade caravans going up the river, and the bridge dwellers do business with them. So, disguised as such traders, we will infiltrate the bridge and lower it. Katya says it still works. They won't be able to stop us if we move fast. And should they try, we'll cross it no matter what those fanatics think. They want blood, they will get it. So now, we only have to wait for the traitor's boat.
Colonel, sir, we can't just leave them here. They will be eaten alive.
Stepan, did you ever try using your head? Do you know where we are going? What we are going to face on the way there? Where, pray tell, are they going to sleep on the Aurora? Atop the coal crates? We Spartans can handle it. But for a woman with a 6-year-old daughter, no less, this is unacceptable.
I'll give them my bedroll and move into the stove.
You will fall asleep and get your throat cut. The next day you'll get guard duty after trying to sleep there.
Still, I know we can't leave them.
Let's just collect that carriage Katya told us about while we wait. We can't leave the child here. And anyhow, how long are we going to sleep in turns for?
Are you starting that again? How, huh? How are we going to collect that carriage? I'm not taking the Aurora there.
Oh, you don't need it. I have a rail car hidden in the terminal. It can tow a carriage like nobody's business. Artyom and I can go get it and bring the carriage back.
No way I'm letting you go. It'll take us both till morning to finish the repairs, and I can't handle it myself in time.
Okay, okay, have it your way. I'm done playing the monster here. We get that carriage, we take the civilians with us. Artyom, will you handle this? Listen, Artyom, if the caravan is sighted, drop everything and rush to the port. It's our best chance of traversing the bridge.
Thanks, Dad. Katya and Nastya will be so grateful.
Here, Artyom, it's a breaker for the rail car. It won't run without this. She's a real babe, Artyomich, no two ways about it. We went to hell and back, here and I. So much stuff you hold, so many tight spots she saved me from. Look, Artyom, since we are going to the terminal, hear me out. It's quite a distance away, and look, if you go at night, there's less of a chance you might run into bandits. They stay at their camps when it's dark. But it's not gonna be easy either, since more beasts come out, and there are also electrical anomalies. The fanatics call them the demons of electricity, so you should think about your options before heading out.
Artyom, Duke is on a mission in that area. He's keeping tabs on the bridge. Reception is bad there. We get mostly static from him. Anyway, if you meet him, he'll update you on the latest developments in the terminal. I bet you've conspired with Anna and Stepan. I care for those two no less than you. But we don't know if what's ahead is any better than the fanatics. I guess we'll have to live and see.
Great job persuading the old man. Check out my setup here, Artyom. I finally got everything the way I wanted. A proper workbench. With storage space for all my tools, and some to spare. You can clean your weapons and make ammo for them here, just like with any other workbench you might find. My gun rack is only available here on the Aurora, though. I'll keep samples of every gun you find, and you can exchange them whenever you want. Always in their best working condition. Oiled and shiny like
Anna,
you.
Thank you and Artyom for helping us. I don't know what would have become of us without you. It is a cursed place. And that's Silantius.
Artyom, are you going to the terminal? You might meet Duke there. He's got an observation post set up in a garage near the bridge.
Artyom, Nastya has something she wants to ask you. Go on, Nastya.
Uncle Artyom, where will you find my tab?
There, that wasn't so hard. See, there are demons nesting somewhere on those storage tanks near the terminal. So could you check if the toy is on one of them? I know this sounds silly, but it was a present from her father, and she doesn't want to leave without it. Look, I'll be in your debt if you do. Oh, and don't do anything risky, of course. One more thing. I heard the guitar coming from that tower. It had a nice sound, but the player, oh, he's just atrocious. I know it's dangerous and all, but if a chance presents itself, save the instrument.
Hey, what are you people doing? Turning our main frequency into a call show? He's got a mission. Don't pile stupid shit on top of it.
Oh, Colonel, sir, we're done already.
I'm just too nice to you all. All right, as you were. Over and out.
Hop!
Well, hello, my blood brother. Didn't see me, huh? The others don't either. I'm basically part of the scenery now.
I heard you were headed to the terminal for the rail car. Then let me fill you in.
The terminal can only be entered by water.
Luckily, there is a dock with a boat nearby, left there by the fanatics, it seems. Inside, there are just those, humanimal mutants, or so it seems. See that gas station? It's a bandit hideout. They ambush the fanatics. These guys seem to be drawn to the terminal like flies to you-know-what. The bandit caught three of them on my watch. Look at the building over there. Bandits keep captives there for ransom or something. But they sure go to town on the poor guys. I asked the colonel for permission to go in three times, but no dice. I understand why, but we have always protected common folk from lowlifes like these. So I'm having a hard time staying put. Oh well. See those ruins? There's a bandit camp there.
Put that bitch down.
Come on, guys! Fucking down! earlier.
The bitch before he runs out on us for good.
Though you are a heretic, we will pray for the salvation of your soul for as long as we live. God bless you.
Prayer is great, but I'd like to thank you with something more substantial. Listen close. There's a room in the terminal. We bring all the sinful things there for the fish to purify them. Here, take this key. You're a sinner anyway, and there might be something of use for you there. Take it.
Simon, you mustn't. Celantius will excommunicate you for that.
He won't if you don't tell him. Or perhaps you'd rather die here, by a heathen's blade.
Oh, of course not.
the boat, you just wait for them to climb in, then spring your trap. They all shit themselves every time.
Hey, have you ever been inside the terminal?
Shit. Why did I have to get so fucking wasted?
Fucking killing me. So, what's inside?
It's royally fucked up.
Damn,
yeah.
He only wishes to make you out of your life.
Fuck this noise.
Turns out
it's their
Celantius.
When he became the boss, he started feeding all the way to that fucking fish.
Shit, that's hardcore as fuck. And to think they call us devils for carving them up. Sure, I cut their throats, but I still let them rot in peace like people. Putting them up as fish snacks. Well, that's really fucked up. I say screw that!
So what else is there? Just the corpses?
Nah, there's also those fucking mutants. So I take the boat into the main hall and the fucks start throwing shit at me and screaming. So I think I'd better leave and then the fucking catfish shows up. It didn't like the noise. So it just leaps out of the water 15 meters high, knocks down the bridge where all the fuckers are gathered and starts chomping. Shit, I can still hear the fucking sound. Give me the creeps.
Well, it's not that bad here, but this shit is fucking boring. It's really, really boring. What the? What the fuck is that? Oh.
You bitch!
I see the bunker! It's behind the concrete slab! I got the big spin!
Die, you fucking bitch!
Guys, gotta reload!
Your ass, your mother!
Was hiding down there.
Boys, this fuckface is hiding somewhere. Gotta find the
One of our guys has been down.
Hey!
It's amazing!
Uncle Arturo,
I knew you had great potential, even back then at the Jammer. Ah, isn't she a beauty?
Artyom, come up here. I have something to talk to you about.
Hello, Artyom.
You're back. You did great. Thank you. So, here's the plan. Your group captures the tugboat. Then you, Duke and Crest, take it to the bridge. While Crest distracts the guards, you and Duke infiltrate the control room at the top and lower the bridge. On your mark, we'll ram the gates, pick you up, and... I pray to God it works out. I can't give you or Duke any direct support. The data we have tells us the enemy's main force is guarding the gate. One more thing, Artyom. Look after Duke, all right? He's a great scout, but prone to unnecessary risks. Sure, he's young, but if he continues like that, who knows what will happen, huh? So give him a good example and do it smoothly and quietly. You are his role model, and as such should remember that you are special forces, not tank jocks. Good luck, Artyom.
Welcome back, Ranger.
So,
thank you,
are you ready for that final push?
I don't even know how to thank you.
Good luck.
Спасибо.
And thanks again. Thank you, Artyom. You are the man. I am in your debt.
here. You made it. I was worried sick while you were running around in that terminal. Yermak said you brought the sleeper carriage. You are simply the best. Sorry, I'm talking so much, but I missed you. Okay, okay, back to business. Damned cough. I guess I spent too much time in that dump. So, they have more guards than we anticipated. It seems risky, but Crest says such caravans are usually commanded by a captain. So if we capture him, the others will surrender. They have about 15 guards. 4 at the tugboat ladder, sentries at the pier. Sam will take the right flank. Come in, Sam.
I'm in position. I can see a guard.
Duke is to the left of the hangar. Come in.
Duke in position, ready to beat the guard off.
Idiot is on the far crane.
Ready for action. Got a mark on everyone on the pier.
Crest has scouted out the basement.
There's only 2 of them here. Busy repairing something, so... this seems to be the best spot for Boetelty.
Well, Artyom, we are all set. You managed to get out of the church quietly, so let's make this one the same.
Yeah, it's no fun beating up immature soldiers like them.
Cut the chatter. All right, Artyom, you're in charge. You call the shots.
Okay, well, it's high time we started. So try to get on that tugboat. We'll give you cover. Let's go over the plan one more time. Once the tugboat is in our hands, Sam, Idiot, and I will go back to the Aurora, while Artyom, Duke, and Crest take the boat to the bridge. Good luck, everyone.
What is there in Africa?
Wait, go away.
Just the marketplace. The city is, you know, gone. But the piers are still there, so once the river got cleaner, they started trading there. I was there too. Helped decontaminate the piers.
Just my luck.
Why have a market there?
Where else? It used to be a big city. Great place for a market. It's just that the gangs took it over. So our skipper left the place. The guys tagged along. At least, those who are still alive.
But how are we supposed to go there now?
Well, we got it covered. They buy all of our wares wholesale, and we get our fuel from them at a special discount. Then we just go up the river, deliver whatever the guys up there need from the south, load up their stuff, and go back down. Easy money, too. We don't have to talk about it.
What the fuck? Some strange noise from over there.
Posts like this get people killed. Huh? Nothing else. I give my job.
Gotta follow the regulations. Check every suspicious shot. Just my luck. Stupid can.
Once again.
What was that just now?
Yeah, they're even going to give me a chance here. What's worse, taking a boat here won't help anyone.
Let's go see what the fuck is going on there.
Careful, on your left. Open fire!
There he is!
Took him out!
That's enough fighting for me!
At least he accepted my surrender. There's that.
I would never surrender to Bennett. But this guy seems different.
Don't shoot! I've laid down my weapons already!
Don't shoot! I can pay the goods. Take them. You can take the goods.
Stay calm. It's us.
Great job, Artyom.
Artyom, all of our guys are fine. You did great. A shame we couldn't do it quietly.
So? You guys ready to set off? Too late if you're not. We have no time to waste.
Good luck, guys. I hope the winds are fair and the waters are smooth. And Artyom, watch it out there.
Oh yeah, we're gonna need that luck, all right. Fair winds.
Hurrah! Man your stations, weigh anchor.
We're gonna go about halfway there, then wait in the reeds until about 4 o'clock. We want to get there early in the morning, when the fog is the thickest and they are sleepy after the morning prayer.
Artyom, it's Duke. We're on final approach. There. See that fire at the very top? That's the control post. What used to be anyway. Now it's a shrine, believe. Closer to God at the top, you see? That's where you have to go. I'll distract the guards now. You are sure? Catch the line!
Ready!
Hey, sailor! What did you do to your barge? What you gonna sell now?
Oh, you're so funny!
Jackass, blade.
So, Artyom, shall we move? Man. Whoever gets there first wins. Break a leg!
Leave the whole side apart. Head to run the barge, you sure?
The Aurora is quietly moving into position. We'll be ready to act on your signal.
Roger that, sir. We're on it. Over.
Because they have arrived. Just like Father Salandios foretold.
Who arrived?
Say to the slaves! It's like you missed the morning sermon.
Well, I didn't.
One day you are going to get sent to fight demons for that.
So early. Just tell me what he said.
All right. A heretic actually arrived right at the ceremony. Our guys rushed over to save the Holy Father.
He also... Just... He's here,
brother! Here. There you go, Sonny Dog! Run, brother! I got the
campfire. That's where she was hiding.
I see that scum! The heathen is at the campfire! There you go, Dirty Dog! They killed you, brothers! That's it, I give
up!
Calm down, I give up!
For protection and solace. Lend your sword in and surrender to the heretic. People say he's not a mere enemy of our congregation. For
us, he didn't protect me.
Open your eyes to the light of his true faith.
Where are those demons? I can't wait any longer to nothing.
Thank you.
Tomb. Look, we're just passing through the blast. Peacefully, our guys don't shoot. We've been easy on you people the whole time. And Katya asked us to take her along herself. Do you get me?
Sure thing. First, you kill off the local cutthroats, and then you switch to us. Will you kill elders and children too? Or have you drunk enough blood already? Leave us for good now. God may punish you for your sins, but my responsibility is to tend my flock.
That's a good boy.
Hear me, brothers. Hold your fire. You hear me? I'll excommunicate everyone who shoots. Well, I did all I could. Just don't shoot. And tell the driver to keep it slow. The bridge is in shambles, so don't stop. Or the bridge might collapse. You will have to jump.
You here didn't reach an agreement. They will let us through if we don't shoot and move forward. Don't stop. I repeat, do not stop. Over.
Artyom, let's jump! Well, that's a job well done, huh?